So today I'm going to discuss the next concept of your artificial intelligence, which is neural networks. Neural network in the sense it is artificial neural network, because our brain is also a group of neurons. Okay, it's also a connection of neurons. So but today what we are going to discuss is not our human brain. We are discussing artificially how a network has been built with the help of neurons. That is what your artificial neural network. So basically, artificial neural network, as in the previous session I already said, that is, it's one type of machine learning strategy, okay, which is a part of your supervised learning. So this artificial neural network is a machine learning. So even the supervised learning is also a part of your machine learning. So in the sense, it is a machine learning approach. So what actually this ANN refers to? This ANN is something like it has been modeled, or it has been inspired by our human brain. So the person who has developed this, they have inspired by our human brain, and they have tried to take the group of neurons in order to get one type of output from the source of given input. Because our brain works in that sense only. How our brain works, the brain will take the inputs from various sources of our body. Okay, it can be anything. It can be from the skin cells, or it can be from any organs. So what it takes the signals as your input signals. And based on that input signals, it processes that signals and it gives you as an action. That is what your output here. In the same case, the neural networks which is artificially made also contains a set of neurons. Okay, so here what is going to happen in this, we are going to discuss that how this architecture looks like and how this is actually performed here. So the thing is that artificial neural network is first thing is a machine learning approach which is inspired by our human brain. Okay, it has been developed by collection of artificial neurons, okay, which are not natural, but it is artificial neurons. And what are neurons? That will going to be discussed right now, that what it neuron contains. That means it contains one set of inputs will be there, and it performs actions on the given inputs, and based on that it will give you a selected output for the given set of inputs. So that neuron, which is actually a part of your artificial neural networks, have fewer connection when you compare with biological neuron. Biological neuron means our brain contains. So what happens, if you compare our human brain, it mostly contains approximately 86 billion neurons in our body, in our brain, I mean. Okay, but if you go with artificial neurons, it will be in thousands, okay, it will be in the multiples of thousands. So that means it will not that much as you compare with our natural neurons, but still it contains some group of neurons here. Okay, so what is actually this neuron? I have said you that neuron is something, a part of your artificial neural network, which receives number of inputs. The inputs in the sense, for example, if I want to decide anything from my side, okay, if I want to perform any action, my brain will instruct me to do that action. So our brain will instruct to do that action. So before that, brain will receive some signals from our body, from our body through sensors, okay, through receptors, you can also say. So anything that will acts on that, and naturally it converts and it give you as an output there, okay. So that is what the thing here, similarly in this neural network also it will do. So who will actually do all this thing? That means taking that input and making that output is actually performed by activation function, which is a very important part of your neuron. Because this activation function, what it does is it takes group of inputs, and that inputs, it will give you, based on that input, it will give you as an output. Okay, so that will be give you as an output here. So that is how the role of activation function. So now we will be discussing some of the examples on that. So how it will be covered. So basically, what is a neural network? First thing we said, artificial neural network. So it contains basically a neuron. I mean, we will be saying neuron model and its architecture. That means only we just doesn't contain only a single neuron, right? So that's why neuron is the actual part of your ANN, that is artificial neural network. That is why it is called as information processing unit of neural networks. Means it takes the information as a form of input and it processes the input with the help of activation function, and it will give you back as an output there. Okay. For example, like you have let us consider ourselves in a natural way. Okay. Now, for example, like if I'm touching a particular thing which our brain says not to touch. Why? Because it is something like it is very cold, or basically if you take not cold, if it is very hot, right? So what our brain say? Not to touch. So brain will give you a signal not to touch, because it is something like it is that our skin, that is our skin cells will not accept that kind of input which is which is you are getting from the particular object when you are touching that, or something like if you get electric shock. So our brain works not to, like suddenly there will be an reply back from a brain that you will pull out from the place where you are getting a shock. So this thing, actually who will do this? It will done by neuron. Okay, that is in the sense of naturally, but the same thing, you know, in a similar way can also be performed by artificially. So that is how, that means this neuron actually do all these things. It will take that information, it will give you, and the information is something like it can be of any form. Okay, the information, it can be of any form. For example, like if you have a fruit is there, right? A fruit is there which you are not sure with which kind of fruit it is, right? And you are actually trying to get out, figure out that what kind of fruit it is. So there will be that you will be thinking something like one kind of fruit, like you are thinking like it is looking like an apple, or it is looking like an orange, it is looking like a mango. That means your mind will take certain different kinds of inputs. Okay, and for every input there is some weightage. That means you have more, that means you will think that okay, it looks like very much similar to apple. Okay, if a new kind of fruit is very if a new kind of fruit is there, and if you want to trace of what kind of fruit is, like you will think in that way, the shape, okay, so the color, the texture of that. So all of these things are required here. So that means the kind of inputs are different, and every input are associated with their weight. What they are associated with? Their weight. So here it is, like this, for example, x1, x2, so on, there will be multiple set of inputs are there, input values. I mean, like if I say fruits are there, so a machine has to understand what kind of fruit is that. Okay, if it is in artificially, like yeah, naturally also, so every input contains some weight which is represented as W1, W2 or something like WM. Okay, so all these are actually what the group of input values, and along with their weights. Weights means weightage of that given input. What kind of weightage is that? Okay, so we actually has to perform summation function. Summation function means we will be multiplying this one. Like here we will be doing x1 w1 plus x2 w2 plus x3 w3 so on up to xm wm. So that will summing function you have to perform here with all the kinds of input you are receiving in this end. Okay, this is your summing function, and in that you will be getting an extra input which is called as bias, which is something like as a constant and acts as an input as like as the input which you have already given this one. Okay, so but this bias, what they have a weightage value as 1. What they have a weightage value as 1. Okay, so you can say that W is equal to 1. Okay, So you have to add this value, B value, and if you represent all this value as U, or you can represent this, all this value as U, then this U plus B, because this is bias, we are adding to the existing input, will give you as V value. What is this V? Induced field. That is what the input, what the neuron, this is how complete neuron diagram, okay? This is just a single neuron. So here, induced field will get the input like this, U plus B. Now, what we are doing is, we are actually performing activation function on this input. That means, for example, if you take pi or f, for example, if I'm taking f here, so f of input means that V, okay? So this function f of V, whatever the value I'll get, suppose if I'll get the value as y, so that value is an output of the given set of input. So this output will let you know that what kind of decision you have to select. For example, if I'm taking an example of any multiple kinds of fruits which are there as an input, and every input has some weightage. So finally, it will give you one output there. Okay, this is actually a fruit. Okay, I mean, this is just an example here. So it can give you some value over there. Okay, so this activation function is very important part, because of this, it will, what is activation function is something, it is processing all these inputs and it give you as a value, as an output. So this is how the role of neuron, okay. So this neuron is something, that's why neuron model or neuron is information processing unit. And what is this architecture? It means we doesn't have just a single neuron. As I said you, it contains multiples of thousands of neurons, okay, in artificial neural network. So you may have set of neurons, and you, every neuron have been connected with their links, which are connecting neurons. That means all the neurons are get connected through a link, and each link has a weight, which I already said you, that how the links have a weight there. So in this way, like, architecture will be there, and a learning algorithm is, this is algorithm is something like how to train the neural network. That means if an input has been given, okay, like, in order to train the neural networks, what we are doing is we are modifying the weights, okay. We are giving different weight values in order to model a particular learning task, because it's a part of machine learning, right? So machine learning will learn by itself. If how it learn by itself, by giving the different weights to that, different data values to that. Based on that, it will analyze that, okay, if this is how it looks like, then it produces that kind of output. So which is actually learning algorithms will be used for training examples. Okay, because as you know, it's a part of your machine learning. So all these three things are a part of your artificial neural network. The neuron itself, and neuron is just a single small entity of your ANN, that is artificial neural network. And in that, it contains a set of neurons and their links. And we have to learn the procedure. I mean, like, how this machine going to train them. Okay, the learning algorithm. So that is what we need to see as part of this one. Now, what is the actual the aim of neural network? The neural network aim is that it is to be trained and generalizes well. Generalizes well means it has to give a generalized output for the given set of inputs. Okay, it shouldn't give like, it should give in a way that it will give a proper output. Okay, how it will give a proper output? By the thing that by the fact that neural network is actually being trained by having some their training examples. So that is what it is, the intention of having this neural networks. And what it should behave correctly on new instances. I mean, if I give new examples, so the thing is that this learning task, because of this training example, it should behave in a correct way. As if you haven't given that example, because that was not the part earlier, but we have included, but it should be in a position, even if I take a new instances, new examples, then it should behave in a correct way. So this is how about the neural network. So now, as I said you, that the basic part of the new artificial neural network is neuron, which I said you just now. So what it contains a set of links. Okay, describe the input wings with weights. So as we have seen this, so these are the links here, which are connecting the input values with their weights. Okay, so multiple links will be there here. An adder function. So this is how I have said you, right? X1 W1 are W1 X1 plus W2 X2 plus X3 W3 are W3 X3. Okay, completely up to till M. Till M in the sense what here? Because we have M input values, we don't know what can be the input. All it depends on the example. It may have the values are not specific, they're not constant, right? So we have just taken as M here. We denoted with M. And for that M, we have an WM weight, because for every input, there is a specific weight will be allotted for that. And we have to perform what? We have to perform summing function with the help of this, what we are adding here. And after this, what we are getting as the U value, right? So, which is, I already said you, this is give you U value upon bias value, U plus B, it will give you as induced field, which is what actual input and the input for your activation function. Okay, so we will be seeing that activation function also. So this activation function pi r f, so what is this? Limiting the amplitude of neuron output, how the output will be there. I mean, like the range has to be specified that this will be the what, this will be the given output, that means up to that range the output will be there. So we are limiting that with the help of activation function. So here, as I said you, f of u plus b, I said you, so you can take pi of u plus b also, because u is what your adder function value and b is your bias, which I said here only, v value. Instead of u plus b, you can also write here as v here, and where you need to mention below that v is what your induced field. So this is how about the neuron diagram. So here we are taking the activation function. Now first, the most important thing is where we need to understand about this activation function. See here, the inputs will not be, always will be in a different format, right? And it will expect the output in a different way. Sometimes output will be like a Boolean value, either to do that work, either not to do that work. So it can be in a two forms, that is 0 or 1, or sometimes the output will be in a continuous way, okay? For every example, for every input, it will give you different kind of outputs. So it that means the output is just not limited only to 0 or 1. It will be between 0 to 1, or the ranges of this output will be quite different. So we will be seeing also that. So before going to activation functions, first, as I said, you bias, right? So this bias has the B value. Okay, that will be added to this, as I just now said you, and it will give you the value of V here. So what is this B? B is actually the effect of applying transformation to the weighted sum U. I mean, whatever the changes you are performing to the sum U, if I'm just getting the transformation, because I said you, X1 value, for B we are taking X1 as 1. So for example, if you elaborate this equation, how it will looks like? W1 X1 plus W2 X2 plus W3 3 X3, so on like that. If it is till M means WM XM, isn't it? So yeah, it is with the 0, first it is starting with 0, not with 1. So here we are adding this W0 X0. Okay, so it is actually X0. So here we taken W0 as B here, and X0 we have taken up previously, only I said you that the value of this will be 1. So this B into 1 will be give you as B. So that B will be added to all these values. So what are these values here? U value. That means this B plus U will give you the value as V, which I said you just now. Okay, so this B will be derived in this way. So where you need to specify in this way? You can specify as well as in this way, or else you can specify like this. If I want to separate B here separately, then I should take here 1 instead of 0, 1 to M. So that you can take in this way. So this is how the bias of a neuron, which is actually an external parameter. It's not a part of your input. It's just an external parameter of the neuron. Okay. which is something just acts like as an extra input for the given input. So that is how about this. Now let's comes to activation function, which is very important part of this concept. So what are actually activation functions? So activation functions means this is where we are using mathematical equations, okay? In order to get the output for the given set of inputs, we are using some set of mathematical equations which will be used to determine the output of a neural network. That means you can get the output by using some mathematical equations. So we will be seeing what is that. So what is the main role of function, activation function? Okay, so every every neuron contains an activation function in the network. I mean in the neural network. So which determines whether it should be activated or not. For example, like I said you, there are two values. If you are taking, if I am giving the output as 1 or else if the output as 0. So here the 1 is something there where the value has been updated or is giving the value as 0 in two way. Either to do the task, either not to do the task, if, based on the given input. Suppose if you are deciding something whether we need to do, that our brain says not to do, that means you are getting the value as 0. If it says 1, so the same thing even applies for ANN, which is artificial neural networks. So this each neuron input is relevant for the model prediction. So it is not something that you will get the values only as 1 or 0, you can get continuous value as well, okay. So that continuous value or the type of value is actually depend on what the neuron's inputs, what the input you are giving, okay. For example, like as I said you that we need to get the, for example, if you have given the fruits example and you need to trace out what kind of fruit is that. So is it not something that we are not following this kind of output, that it is not that. If the question is that whether the from the given, whether if you have taken from one fruit, whether we need to say whether it is an apple or not, or any kind of fruit which you haven't seen it, they have just said that whether it is there or not, in that sense it will give you 1 or 0. But in the other sense, if I want to pick any one of those one, then that is the output will be different. So based on the given neuron inputs, the prediction, the model, actually these are predicted model, right? Because it is something we're predicting. If we doesn't have any knowledge in our, if you say naturally also, we cannot say exactly 100% that it is to be, but it is something which is giving predictions, what it is giving predictions. So that's the reason why the activation functions are being used here to normalize the output. Normalizing the output in the sense, if you have given multiple set of inputs and you are getting only a output as a single value, then it is something you are normalizing the output, right? So that when you are normalizing the output, what range it supports, mainly the range of the output will be between 1 and 0. Because if there is a predictability will be there. Predictability means something like you can have a value which is not sure, which is not for sure. That means you cannot say that it is 100%. If it is 100% means you will get a value as 1. And if you say 100% no, that is 0% means 0. If you are not sure about that, then there will be a predicting value which is between 1 and 0. Similarly, you may have a value between minus 1 and 1. Okay. But mostly the activation function will be 1 and 0. We will see both of that. Okay. So the actual additional aspect of activation function is that they must be computationally efficient. What is the main thing of activation function is the efficiency should be more. That means even if the inputs have been given more, they should be in a position to determine the output. Okay. And they are computationally efficient means they should handle the complex data as well. Okay. So because here there is not a case of only a single neuron, you may have multiple thousands of neurons for each just data sample, not for all the data sample. Remember, only for just single data sample, you may have multiple millions, thousands or millions of neurons. So at that time, it will be very challenging that if I take a normal activation function, then it won't give you that much efficiently. With much efficacy, it won't produce. So that for that purpose, it should be computationally very much efficient. But presently, modern neural networks, what it uses, it uses backpropagation. Actually, it is to train the model. Okay, training the model. Because I said you here, learning algorithm is there, right? So in that one, you can use backpropagation algorithm, which is used to learn the artificial neural networks. Okay, so that will be a part of that. Okay, so which is actually like to train the model, that the main purpose of training the model is to improve the computational efficiency. That means there should be computationally well. How? Because if you give more strain on the activation function, they should be in a position to still, it should give you the consistent result or more than that. Okay, and it's derivative function, whatever the function which is going to be get derived by an activation function. So the function, whatever, I mean like the activation function, okay, so it is just a function, get the output of a node. So you can say something like a transfer function, okay, and the activation function is used to determine the output of a neural network, which I said you, right, yes or no. If it is Boolean, means 0 or 1, which is you can say yes or no, or else it can be values between 0 to 1 or minus 1 to 1. Just now I have said you, okay, for that one. Now first we are going to the next function, which is step function. Okay, before step function, we will go first to linear function, or you can simply call as identity function. Linear function is a very simple in a way, because at the name itself indicates that it's a linear way. Linear means there won't be any change to the given output. Whatever the input you have given, the same value it predicts. Okay, so for that purpose, there is no range limitations also, because the output, the input can be any value. So the output will be the same value. That's why there won't be any specific range. That's why the range is from minus infinity to plus infinity, because it will give you the same value here. So the problem of this linear or activation function is it cannot handle the complex data, because mostly this neural networks are used wherever the data is complex. Like if you take this example here, if you have an input as 0, it will give you as 0, right? If you have a input as 2, it will give you, if you have input as output as input as 2, output will give you as 2, and if you have input as 4, it will give you output as 4. So linearly, even for negative value also, it will, if it is minus 2, then it will give you as minus 2, then minus 4, okay, then minus 6, so on. So that's why minus infinity to plus infinity will be the range here. So it, the line itself shows that it's a linear function. So no changes, that's why you can call them an identity function. Whatever the value which you have taken as an input, it will give you the same value, no changes at all. Okay, so it is not at all, it is not at all advisable to use this function, because it doesn't achieve the purpose of taking the neural networks. The purpose is something like to get the refined output. Are you getting the refined output? No, not at all. The same thing, whatever you are given as a, as and when you are getting the same thing, then there is no role of getting this function. But next about this step function. Okay, this step function is somewhat different when you compare with the last function. Step function is something like it will give you the value in a two way, either as 1 or 0. I mean like it's like a Boolean value. It says either to do or not to do, or either to accept or not to accept. That's why what happens is if the input sum, that means here if you refer this, up to this point the value is 0, but all of a sudden what happens, the value has increased to 1. That means it just gave you only this value. That's why the line is straight. Here it is completely 1 and here it is completely 0, right? So what happens, all of a sudden when it reaches to one threshold value, so here, from here to here it is 0, as in when it reaches to this point, threshold point, suddenly it has taken a value of 1. Okay, that's why it's like a step function, means you are not going like in a smooth way, you're going in a step by step way. So, okay, so for example, like if you are like if you are touching to any utensils which is very hot, what happens? The amount of temperature is that much that your skin cells doesn't handle that thing. So what happens normally? We won't touch. Or else if we touch also suddenly we ripple back of that. So the amount of temperature by which our skin doesn't accept is what your threshold value. Okay. So as it when reaches to threshold value, suddenly it will go to the one value. So that's why up to whenever the value is below threshold value, it maintains the value called zero. Okay, whenever it reaches to threshold value, it goes to one. So this threshold value is the deciding factor in step function, which will decide either you should accept that or you shouldn't accept that. Okay, so that kind of example is this. Now the next is about sigmoid or logistic activation function. This is something like the values are not specific here. Previously we have seen that identity function you are getting the same output, and previous in the step function we are seeing either you are getting the output either completely 0 or 1. But here the values are something which is in between 0 and 1. It's not 0 and 1, it is in between 0 and 1, means any value it can be there. Okay, that's why the curve what is obtained is a smooth curve and it is in S shape. Okay, something like as an S shape. So that's why it is to be termed as sigmoid function. How you will be calculating? For example, you have X as an input. Okay, if you have X as an input, so the resulting F of X, okay, this X as an input, so F of X is your activation function. So by performing this, you will get the values in between 0, 1. I mean between 0 and 1 only. Okay, that's why the complete range will be between 0 and 1. Okay, so how it will be like? As we have taken exponent, right? Because here we have taken 1 by 1 plus exponent of minus x. So as we take an exponent here, so because of exponent, you know, naturally you know that exponent if I take, so the value never reaches 0 nor exceed 1. Okay, so it won't exceed 1 because it will be in between both of that. For example, if the input is something which is large negative number, so what happens? It will just scale down to 0 because it will be in between 0 and 1, means if it is very much negative, then it will be scaled down near towards 0, means near to 0. And if it is too large, I mean too positive number, then it will be scaled towards 1, means it will be very much near to 1. So in that sense, the range will be there. So by the range, by the value itself, you can get that whether it's a negative number or whether the number is a positive number. So this is how about sigmoid function, okay, which is nonlinear, which is something like a smooth function. That means it is using in the curve. What is obtaining is in a smooth way. Okay. So this is how about sigmoid function. The next thing is about tan h function, which is also termed as hyperbolic tangent function. So what is this tan h function? See, previously in the previous function just now we have seen the value is in between 0 to 1, but here the values are in between minus 1 to 1 plus 1. Okay, so how you are getting by, like, means here also you need to apply threshold just like as we did in the previous one. So here we need to perform by applying the threshold value, the values will be obtained in between the given range. What is the advantage is that it is zero centered. Zero centered means like here it is origin, right? So here it is zero. So it can have a zero value also. That's why it is zero centered. Previously in sigmoid it is not zero here. So it is zero. So here it won't be there. So that's why it's not zero centered, but here it is zero centered. And here if you see the values are between 1 to 1, like this it will be plus 1 to minus 1. So like that the range will be there here. Okay. So what happens whenever we applied the weighted sum? So remember here, whenever this x, if I take this x or in any x, that is your weighted sum. Okay, that is your induced field, you can say. So the weighted sum of the inputs in the tan h of x, it rescales the value. I mean, the definitely I said you that it is in between minus 1 to plus 1. So what happens here, the large negative numbers are scaled towards minus, as simple as that, because that is from 0 to 1. So that's why it is 0 towards 0. But this in tan h, it is when it is scaled down towards minus 1 means it is negative numbers, and if it is positive numbers means it is towards 1. Right? So this is how about hyperbolic tangent function. The next thing is about next, again, this is also one activation function, so which is rectified linear unit. So that's why you can simply call a ReLU. Okay, you can, you won't get like this, you may get only like this ReLU. Then also you should be in a position to understand what is this. Okay, so this is actually the most widely used activation function, because there are some benefits here. Previously, if you observe here, even for the negative values, it is getting the negative output, right? And for positive value only, it will give you positive output. But output here, what it is giving is, it is not giving output as a negative value. It is just giving the value starting from 0 to max. That means max is also a positive number. So what happens, it allows only which are positive, and negative values are not passed here. So because negative values, in the sense, it will decrease the efficiency. So because of that, what happens, it will speed up the process, because it won't consider negative values, and simply, and it will negate or bring down possibility of occurrence of dead neuron. Dead neuron is something like, whenever it won't works, that is your dead neuron, will that will have a negative impact, negative values. So it won't consider dead neurons, it will just consider the neurons which are actually working, and it will give you a positive values. So for that purpose only, this ReLU is a widely used activation function. So this function is actually allow the maximum value to pass during the front propagation. Front propagation means that going into the forward in direction. So what happens is, there is no limit in the positive numbers. Here it is, right? So if you observe this, whenever the input is something like less than zero, so the values are linear, so it just won't change the values. But as soon as it reaches to the positive values, the function is increasing. Okay, that means the line is inclining towards a positive numbers here, indicating that the range is from zero to all positive numbers. Okay, so that's why the max of 0 comma x, I mean, if you have negative value, if x is negative, then it will consider 0. But if x is positive, that means if it is greater than 0, so it will consider x value. That's why you are using max operation here. So the but drawback is also there here. The drawback of ReLU is, whenever the gradient hits 0 for the negative value, it does not converge toward the minima. I mean, like, it will not be used in propagation process. So this propagation is something like to learn the technique. I mean, like I said you in propagation algorithm, that it is used for learning the algorithm. But as you know, for dead neurons, it won't consider the result. So it won't be useful for performing the propagation process. So that is one kind of drawback in ReLU. Okay. So this is how about ReLU activation function. So there are still various other functions as well. But this is how something where which are most important, which is something called ReLU. Or you may find the most important here is sigmoid function. Sigmoid activation function. Okay. So this is how what we have covered in today's session. So in the next session, we will be discussing what are the forms of, here we will be discussing architectures here. Because I said, I have just explained you how a single neuron will be there, how it will process, what kind of activation functions mostly it uses. So that we have discussed. We haven't discussed so far right now the architecture. So architectures contains, you know, set of neurons. That is what the most important thing here, because it doesn't contain only single neuron, it contains set of, because we don't know what kind of input we are giving. So for every input, there will be associated neuron will be there, and that neuron will going to handle it with the help of activation function. It will give you appropriate output for the given inputs. Okay, So with this, I wind up this today's session. So thank you.